Hi guys, it is me, your instructor, Cheryl Davis. Just wanted to go over this sheet for a minute because this is very important. This is very important for our CMA and our phlebotomy, especially phlebotomy. You will be doing this every day. It does not ever go away. So if you look at your left, you have your tube stopper colors. Yellow, we always know, is first, so we try not to emphasize that because that yellow tube is actually and can be different colors, but they will always be for microbiology for blood cultures, and that's a blood culture tube. We also have a yellow tube that's for something else, so we try not to remember yellow as that blood culture tube unless it says yellow SPS tube. Then we're going to know it's a blood culture tube. So, for our order of draw, it's blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. I know you see all those other colors, but if you'll see that red, plain, and red, and gold color tubes are in a color group. So, we put them in the same group, and we just call it gold. Then we have the green. Then we have the lavender and pink. We actually put them in a color group as well. And if you look to the right of that, it has what additive is in it. So in this tube, we're at the lavender and pink tubes. They are, and both have EDTA in them. So that what keeps them in their color group. Same with the red and gold. They are very special. They are different in that they are the only tubes that we're going to test serum in. Go all the way to the left over there where it says serum. And that's what we're testing in them. All the other tubes are plasma. So what are the only tubes that we're going to test serum in? It's going to be your red gold group. And then we have our gray, which is at the end. Gray, I want you to remember lactic acid is one that you'll see, and glucose. So go ahead and finish out that wordage for glucose. Is there GLUC, but put glucose for me, and that will, I want you to think great glucose. There's another tube that glucose can go in, but it is for a fast glucose, and normally you're not going to just run and do a glucose blood. You can do a finger stick for that to be fast, but if it has to be done now, it will be in that green tube for a stat test fast. That's what that means. So again, let's go over the color. Blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. I mean, y'all can group them up, but blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. Get that in your head. Don't let it go because you will need that. That is also one of our tests we're going to have. Blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. That's all I want you to say or write. And we'll figure that one out later, but I need you to know those, the order of draw is what we call it. Also, come to the next column, which it tells you what additive is in there. So the additive that is in your blue is sodium citrate. Come on over. It is always for clotting. Your light blue is for clotting. You will remember, if you've remembered your vocabulary words, thrombocyte or thrombosis. And that's actually what the T stands for there. PT and PTT stands for partial thromboblastin time or partial thromboblastin. That's what the PTT stands for. And you can even write thrombin there, someone has on the one I have here. And that will help you remember PT, PTT goes in a light blue tube for clotting. And thrombocytes cause clotting, which is your also another name for platelets. So, and we test plasma in that. Then you got your red gold group. We're going to put that together. They do not have anything in there. If it does have something in there, it's a clot activator. All these other ones have anticoagulants in them, because we don't want them to clot. We do want our red gold to clot. It takes about 30 to 60 seconds for it to clot inside the tube. But a lot of times, most of your chemistries or routine chemistries are dead in your red gold group. A lot of times those are have nothing in them. When they get to the lab, they'll put them in there, whatever color and whatever things they need to do with them. We test serum in our red gold group. That's the only colors we test serum in, is red gold group. Then we have our green, heparin green, you know what I mean. You'll hear that in one of your songs. And I like those songs. If you listen to it after, you understand it a little better, it'll even help you remember it even more. So then your green has your heparin in it, heparin green. Then that has your BMP and CMP in it. Your BMP is your basic metabolic profile, and CMP is complete metabolic profile. So your metabolic profiles will go in a green tube, along with troponin, K. Then you have some special tubes that, not special tubes, but special tests that go inside that green tube as well. Bilirubin, this one does not have ammonia. Add ammonia there up under bilirubin. Bilirubin is light sensitive. We have to cover it with aluminum foil to carry it to where it needs to go, because light will mess it up. You would know a high bilirubin. A lot of babies have that when they are first out, and they put them under the light. The light helps bilirubin come out of their system. So that is why we are going to have to protect it so we can get a real level on that bilirubin. Ammonia should also be there as well. How we protect ammonia or transport ammonia is in icy water. Has to be in some icy water. In a cup of icy water, a biohazard bag with some ice in it, but put a little water in it so it covers the whole tube. Those are your two special tubes or tests that go in the green tube. And again, we're testing plasma. Your lavender and pink, we got to remember EDTA is in there. Going to hematology, most of the time these are our big timers. We're doing the CBC, which is your most abundantly tested test out there, complete blood count. That's exactly what it stands for. It's counting all the blood particles that are in your blood. And estimated SED rate, ESR, is also there as well. But complete blood count is your main one in there. For the pink antibody screens, type and cross match is what pink is normally used for and known for as well. And we test plasma in them as well. Then you have your gray tube, which has sodium fluoride. It is very special in that it inhibits glycolysis, meaning it inhibits the breakdown of glucose. That's why we test it in a gray tube. If we test it in the other tube, we have to hurry up and test it, or it will break down your glucose. So we put it in a gray tube so we can get it to the lab within 2 hours, is mostly when we need to get our gray tubes to the lab, and all the other tubes, mostly 2 hours. Your gray tube has sodium fluoride in it. It inhibits glycolysis. Anything with lysis on the end of it, or phagocytosis, or anything to do with breakdown is what that means. Inhibits glycolysis. It inhibits the breakdown of glucose. So that's why we use that tube to test glucose. And lactic acid, which is also a buildup that is caused by diabetes as well. So if we're testing anything with diabetes, probably going to be testing a glucose level in that gray tube. And also plasma. So if you look all the way to your right, you've got your plasma, serum, plasma. So the only tubes that we're going to test serum in is your red gold tubes. Okay? Always remember that. Your main tubes are these as well. Your light blue, red gold, green, lavender, gray. So blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. Blue, gold, green, lavender, gray. That is your order of draw. I wanted to break this down so y'all could hear it, and it always is better to explain this chart because you will have to remember this chart. Most of your midterm exam is gonna come straight off this chart, pretty much what's in a green tube. when I say what's in a green tube, that's what's already in there. These anticoagulants are already in those tubes. So when I say what's in a green tube, you'll say heparin. What tests go in the tube, you'll say BMP, CMP, bilirubin, ammonia, and you do your list. What goes in a lavender tube? EDTA is in lavender tubes. What test are we doing in a lavender tube? CBC. Okay, pink, type and cross match, gray, glucose. And those are our tubes. Again, we tried, remember, your first tubes can be all kind of color, so I don't want you to just specify yellow, because there's another yellow tube that we'll learn a little later that we'll add to this. But in the beginning, always blood cultures go first, because we don't want to contaminate the other with it with anything else. So the cleanest sample would be your first, which goes in the yellow tubes if you have a blood culture. That's why they are very, very, very specific in having them first. Just saying that your blood culture tubes can be all colors, including yellow. But if I say yellow SPS, we're going to know it's for blood culture. Going to microbiology. All right. See y'all when it's test time.